All right, integral of sine pi x. On this one, the only thing that makes it more complicated than trying to compute like the integral of sine x is that there's just a little constant multiple there in the argument. So that means whatever this came from, the chain rule would be messing around with it. So like if it came from a cosine pi x, more or less, the chain rule would have tacked on a factor of pi. So what I do to get this integral done is just set myself up with what looks like the consequence of the chain rule. In other words, the derivative of the interior stuck right next to this function. I can't just go around multiplying things by pi, but constants move in and out of integrals with no problem. So this is legitimate. All right, so now I have the consequences of the chain rule sitting right here, and I'm really just trying to guess the antiderivative of the sine function, which is just a negative of a cosine. Oops. And if I check that real quick, I differentiate cosine pi x. It gives me negative sine pi x. That kills this minus sign. Then the chain rule says you've got to multiply by the derivative of the interior, which gives me that pi. So it works. And I end up with negative 1 over pi cosine pi x. Plus c.